Are you struggling to organize and streamline your workflow using Airtable? Well, if so, you do not want to miss this video. I'm going to be going into detail on exactly this thing for a process that I'm currently working on within my own business. I'm going to be leveraging the power of the new interfaces tool that Airtable recently released. So if exploring this in its full entirety is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where I'm going to help you save up to 20 hours per week with no code, tools, and automation. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, check the links below because I have an ongoing webinar that is available to you. You can explore the basic fundamental building blocks of putting together automation so that you can start leveraging these tools and reclaim your time, save all kinds of effort, and ultimately work less but earn more. If that's of interest, do check the links below. Again, the link for that is garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get all signed up. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this. I am working within the Interface Designer to streamline a process that I've had inside of Gap Consulting for a while now. Specifically, I'm talking about my flagship course. Now, you don't have to necessarily use interfaces to be building out your own online course, but I'm gonna share with you how I'm using it in conjunction with working with my virtual assistant so that we can make sure that we get everything done and our course revamp gets complete and looks really polished and clean at the end of it. So let's go ahead and hop into my screen. First thing I want to draw your attention to is the upper corner of Airtable here where we look at our different tables. And before we get into the interface, we always have to make sure that we have the right database structure. Now in this case, I'm only working with chapters and lessons, and this is pretty straightforward. When you do a course, if you have any online course, you generally break your lectures or your lessons up into chapters. So chapter is kind of the mega, and then inside of that, you've got the individual lessons. So for me, I have these 7 different chapters, all the way from mapping out your process to, you know, building your database to automating it, and then into building your Airtable interface, which is the new chapter I'm adding. Now, the other part, of course, that ties to this is the lessons. So flipping into lessons, we have a connection to the chapter. So each of these is its own lesson related to a particular chapter. So let me break down for you what kind of data I want to store in here so that I can then turn over to the interface and show you how it works in action. So back on chapters, this is high level, pretty straightforward. You have your linked relationship to the lesson. Of course, each chapter has its name. Then I keep a thumbnail for the chapter as well. So, you know, inside of my course software, I upload the thumbnail for the chapter, the thumbnail for the lesson. And so that's where I'm storing this. I just have it directly there in my asset. And here's the magic part is the asset URL. So inside of Google Drive is where I'm going to be storing all my raw files. And the process looks like this. I'm going to record the raw file. I upload it to Google Drive. That changes the status of where the particular lesson is. My assistant comes in, edits that video down, lets me know that it's ready for the next phase. Then we upload that finished video into our course software, which in our case is Kajabi, but whatever it is for you. And then of course we need to get closed captions and things like that in as well so that our course is fully accessible to everyone. Okay, so popping into this asset URL, this is where we can just open it up and you're gonna see all the different chapters, right? And then of course, going into a chapter, you're gonna get a breakdown inside of the chapter of the different lessons. And right now we haven't actually started this yet, we've just built the database to support the framework. So let's go back here, back to Airtable. We also have a button that's gonna open it in Drive because the button just looks way cooler than having a URL floating around, right? Okay. In the lessons, kind of the same deal. We have a name for the lesson. We have the chapter. I bring in the chapter order, which is a hidden field. This helps me sort them in the particular order because if I didn't try to group and sort by the chapter order, it tries to go alphabetically by the chapter title, which kind of breaks it down, right? Check this out. If I group by chapter, it puts everything out of whack. Alphabetically, it says architecture base, and this is the 3rd chapter. So I don't want that. I like to go by the chapter order, which if I flip back to chapters, just to kind of share that, it's just a hidden field here that is numerically ranking these different chapters. Okay, back in the lessons though, I've got a link to my chapter. I have a status of the lesson, and this is going to come into play in a minute. Then, of course, each of these folders is a subfolder inside of the chapter in Google Drive, and so I have that particular piece as well. Then I have the button that's going to open up Google Drive. Then I have the order of the lesson. And this ordering, guys, it really comes in handy. I've got a chapter order, I've got a lesson order, and then I also want to check out my folder name. Now, I don't want to have to manually type out the folder name when I'm creating it. It's way easier to copy and paste. And so I built a formula that's just going to create that folder name for me. And again, I'm using numbers here because, as you might suspect, Google Drive, it also wants to rank things alphabetically. So check this out. Back in Google Drive, if you're having a hard time keeping things in order, you know, all you have to do is put some numeric value in front, and now suddenly you can rank by name, sort in that particular order, and it looks clean because you have numbers. Okay, so jumping back into Airtable, a couple more things. I've got some checkboxes, raw files, video edited, and captions uploaded. And this is taking into account where we are in the phase. Have the raw files been complete? If yes, that box gets checked. Have the raw files been edited into a complete video? If yes, second box gets checked. And as soon as the captions are uploaded, third box gets checked. Now I have an overall ordering. This is combining the chapter order and the order and separating it with a period in the middle. So this is a really nice way for you to keep like an overarching order for things. So here, chapter 1.lesson 1 is 1.1. So again, if you're ever struggling to keep things in order, try remembering this numeric ordering system. Now I also have my Kajabi URL, and this is the place the asset needs to be uploaded to when it's fully complete. So when we finish that video, when we finish those closed captions, they need to get uploaded. And so again, I've created a URL here that's gonna pop me directly in there. Or again, I wanna hit that button because it looks way cleaner, right? So it takes me right to that particular lesson. And as you can see, this is the old lesson from 3 years ago that I need to revise, and that's the whole point of doing this course revision. Okay, so let's talk about how interfaces have helped us to streamline this process. Going to the interfaces here, we have different stages of the different elements for this course. It's either waiting to be recorded, it's either waiting to be edited, or it's getting captions, or it's 100% complete. So dropping in here, check it out. I've got this particular interface filtering only those lessons that are in the lesson status of not started, meaning it's ready to go. But I have on my interface all the fun buttons, so I can pop it open it up in Google Drive. I see what chapter it belongs to. But imagine that I finished recording this and I was ready to move chapter intro for the Map Your Process chapter. Imagine I was ready to move that into the next phase. Pretty simple to do so. All I have to do is check the box that says, hey, this raw file has been filmed and uploaded to Google Drive. And as soon as I do that, you see that Airtable, because of an automation, turns it into the next status. It has been recorded and is now awaiting edit. We no longer will find that particular lesson here because it's not in the proper status for this particular section of our interface. So let's drill out. We can expand our interface, and again, it's not in the ready to record area, it's now awaiting edit. So if we click on awaiting edit, now we see the chapter intro for Map Your Process, that's chapter 1.lesson 1, and it's in the recorded awaiting edit phase. Once my assistant has completed the edit and uploaded the finished video to our Google Drive, again, using the link right here, all he has to do is check that box, and within a moment or two, we're gonna watch that lesson status get updated to edited and awaiting captions. Now, again, in the final stage, we can go into awaiting captions. And here, as you might imagine, we've built a filter so that all of our lessons are in this particular status. And so now it's just waiting for the final stage, which is upload the captions to our course platform. And so once the captions have been created and uploaded, the box gets checked here. The status for this particular lesson will be marked complete thanks to a fancy automation. And then we can go into the completed lessons at any point in time and get a full list of all the ones there. So I hope you see how we can actually work with a particular record through a process. And I made this really rudimentary just by using check boxes, but of course you could build some much fancier automations and use other statuses or any other number of triggers in order to initiate your automation. I hope that this got the wheels turning and made you think of new and exciting ways that you can work within your team to get the insight you need inside of interfaces within Airtable. I hope you got a ton of value from this. If you did, make sure you subscribe to the channel and give this a thumbs up. It really helps the YouTube algorithm so that we can reach more no-coders like you. And I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly. And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.